Good evening, this is Draco, and we are continuing the run we started last time. We are 2-0 in the Modern League, and we are playing this really sweet list that managed to do well in the Modern Channels last weekend. And I gotta say that I'm really excited for Merfolk right now. I think really that the deck is doing great. I just watched also in France, there was a big Modern tournament, and Modern Merfolk were doing well again. This is the list we're running in this league here. It's a list that still run 3 Force Negation, 3 Subtleties. Of course, you have the Vodalion Hexcatchers, which is a great card, and it's been performing so great as a, you know, modal counterspell, and also just Instant Speed Lord is really strong. And of course, all the other normal 2-drops we have here. Testing out Rishan and Dockhand for this list, and I think it's been performing better than I expected it to do. Simply because you want to have more 1-drops with Hexcatcher, then it makes more sense to have more 1-drops. And I think the Dockhand is doing okay, and 2 toughness is actually pretty relevant. But we're 2-0 in the league. We managed to beat out Burn. We managed to beat what's the other matchup we managed to win? I think it was Scapeshift or something. Wasn't it? No, I don't even remember. It was against Cookie Snow. Okay, that's fine. Anyway, we'll get into the round right now. Hopefully we can continue the good run. Hopefully we can get a good score here. This hand's kind of slow. Don't think I can mulligan it. We're on the draw, so I think this is okay. It's not the best hand. We'll make do. Oh my god! The mirror. I wanted to force negation either while here. He does know what he's up against. This hand is not the worst for the mirror. Having the mass is much better than the Lord. But you can see Merfolk is popping up all over the place. Back in the days, I used to never meet Merfolk when I played on Magic Online. Never ever. Okay, Adept here. Yeah, that's fine. Good hand, no islands, it's pretty good. Let's just DM some Masters. Then we just stack up on Lords here. He can never play an island then. Oh my god, he walked right into that one. I have to... I think I have to subtlety this Velu. Okay, Hexcatcher. It can be countered, but it can't be subtleted. And it actually makes my force negation really bad. So we could consider subtleting, pitching the force, and then playing out Svealoon. This is a bit aggressive, but I think it's worth it. He buttoned it, okay. Tail Shaper. Let's see if he has his own. Here is where he'll subtlety. He didn't. Okay, good. Sometimes the Merfolk play. Okay. So now he can do us 6 points of damage. Yeah, that's a lot of damage. So here I think we'll just attack with both, he won't block anyway. We need to draw from the Saint Lune at least. Perfect, that's a land, that's what we needed. So hope he doesn't have any more masters here. I can trick to the master and start blocking. Starting out islands is the right way to go. Okay, that's game. Oh, what can we do here? We can tap down. Oh, it's not necessarily game. We could just tap down this one. Then we take. I should take 9. Okay. Okay, this mirror is good here. We also like. Brazen Borrow is okay just to bounce something sometime. I think Subtlety can be decent. I don't really like the rest of that stuff here. Dark Hand is pretty good to tap down Mudavald, I think. Just be an early blocker. Don't like Force Negation in this matchup. Then maybe we'll just do this. So what are we countering, you know? It's like, yeah, Idavile, that's a great counter target, but what if you don't draw that? I think Subtleties are decent, but not as a 4 off. So I'll do like this. Yes. Keep. Great hand here. Really want to be able to win the mirror, especially because I expect Merfolk to be the big tier 1 deck soon, right? It's gonna be all over the place. Okay, let's see how long we can go without playing Island. Probably not that long. I really wanted to draw Minamu now. Could consider siding out Lords actually. No. Oh, the slow hand. I was nervous about something fast here. Brazen Borrow is also good at bouncing either vials. Okay, nothing yet. Just showing a Lord here is fine. Okay. Damn, he has Mystical Dispute. That's great in the mirror. Yeah. I think we need to push damage here. Not looking that great since we don't draw lands here. And our lords are buffing his lords. So I'm not a big fan of this case here. Okay. We're gonna take so much damage now next turn. I don't think we can do that. I think we need to Trickster. I think I draw a stall. Maybe we should cut out the lords actually in the mirror. What is it considering here? Okay. I don't know why he wanted to dismember that. Okay. We're still losing higher, so it doesn't really matter. Maybe I want to take this up so we can get Svealun down. Problem is that I'm gonna lose to these guys here. No, can't do that. And we are dead if we play our own lord.
I said it before and I'll say it again.
But we can win next turn. If he doesn't kill us now. But he only needs to have one lord. So we gotta play the Lord of Atlantis in end step. That way we could do 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And then that's lethal. If he doesn't have a lord, we got this. It's only 9 points of damage he's doing to us. A tricky thing we could do is also putting in the Lord and sacking it. To counter something. But then it doesn't buff his team. That's a Lord. So you won. You were slow to play that. Okay, so we got smacked totally by Merfolk in the mirror. And we are back for round 4 here. Let's play first against Sobra. Nah, nice hand this. Keep this. What a beautiful hand. Let's get down this nice bronze Idavile here. Let's see what we're up against. Burn, okay. Looks like it could be burn. Let's draw a Tide Shaper here, that would be pretty nice. Or a Resident Dark Hand. Moodwalt, okay. Still think I just want to run out the Adept. Then if he burns it, he has to use mana on that. Yeah. Ooh, that's a side saber. So we have another option. pretty sweet. So if you shoot out the adept, we can just chase your brain and block the dragon man. Pretty nice mount on this one. I like the full art ones there as well. They're also pretty sweet. He's considering killing the adept. Maybe because of him, he's missing lands. Yeah, he is. Okay, then we're definitely gonna tie here, Bryn. And block here. This is a great draw. The tie was a nice draw. And now he's really back to the Dark Ages. Ooh, with the Sega. Oof. Now I want the... Now I really want the Tide Shaper. Maybe draw it here. Svelun is also great. Let's just put in Svelun. And then we have Hexcatcher up to potentially counter something. We can create a 2-2 now from the Ursa. Svelun was a good draw, not gonna lie. Okay. He's just gonna make the construct, so let's just put in the Adept here. I want to see if I can draw a Tide Shaper. It's a Lord. And Otavara, that's beautiful. That's beautiful. Then I think that it's just Otavara, whatever he plays here, and then I just tackle these two. He can create a 2-2 and block the adept if he wants to. I think actually I'll let him do that, and then I can play the Hexcatcher and put in the Lord. See here. Overloading him with pressure here. Then the construct token just dies, it takes 5 points of damage. And I'll keep the Otavara because that's just a great play to bounce something. And now you should consider, am I really gonna, you know, use all my time creating these construct tokens? Yeah, won't work. Okay, so then we're gonna get enough spreading seas and dismembers. But I didn't see enough otherwise to put in other things. But it's a red deck, so maybe Kira is just in general gonna be good. We saw Lightning Bolt, so that's probably good. But I think in this matchup, I don't think I like the Force Negations, so I'll take those out. So it's a bit better on the draw here. And I'll cut one Hexcatcher in this matchup. I don't think it's filled with non-creature spells, so let's just cut one of those. Brazen Borrow is actually decent against... Is that okay? Is that okay? Ah. Alright, putting in one Brazen Borrow, cut down our Svelun. We don't want to overstack our 3-drop spot, and we have Kira's ready, put in already. A little bit of interaction is good. I'll keep this hand. We have the Trickster against early Ragavan. Not the best. If he has a Ragavan, this is not the best. But we do have Spreading Seas, which I like against the Ursa Saga. Okay, he mulliganed. No Ragland, please. His hand is not good against Ragland.
Not good at all.
Okay. Is that red, some sort of red? Oh, I drew the Aether Vial. That's pretty nice. We are going to save the Spring Seas for just a second. We're doing Synthwave and Magic Cards. Oh my god. Now I'm actually wondering, should I go for Spreading Seas? Spreading Seas on to Mana Deny him here. I think it actually might be worth it. I hate myself if this is wrong, but if he had the Ursae, he would play it here, and I think it's just such a much a bit better card. Tide Chipper. Now we have the backup. So if he plays the Springs, the Ursae, we have the backup. Otherwise, we could just put in Tide Chipper and Double Lord. Because I would much rather one. Ooh, that's the Ursae. Damn. Okay. Fable. Okay, that's good. It's a good card. We just gotta take out that Ursa Saga right away. And then we can Trickster the token so he doesn't get any value, and then we can Double Lord next turn, not potentially Triple Lord. Definitely gonna tap down the Shaman token. It's a pretty nice card. Of course, if you like what I do here, if you like the content, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'm really close at 700 subscribers, so that feels great. So thanks for following, guys. That really means a lot. Really means a lot. Yeah, nothing we can do about that. He wanted to clear the way for the Shaman, so this is also kind of awkward for him. Now he wasted a bolt on a 1-1. It was a 2-2 because of the Spring Seas. See, we are really denying him a lot here. This is going to stay on 2, and I think I actually want to crack the Warlock Grove if I don't draw anything bigger. Let's just go all Lords here, right? Definitely want to do this and hit for 4, and I think I'm considering if I should hold the Hexcatcher. Yeah, let's do that. It's just a nice, if I, bait in a burn spell or something. And now he'll get a Kiki Jiki. We are throwing a lot of damage next turn. 5 plus, so the 8. Yeah, it's lethal next turn. We can't do nothing against that. That's not cool, bro. he doesn't have a lightning bolt here, then we would actually be really far behind. Now it's only 9 points of damage, so that was actually a setback. Ragavan dashed. Okay, so he's gonna go all in here. You get the treasure token, but we'll kill off the Ragavan. Hopefully it doesn't have any more removal spells from the treasure token. That would be actually pretty rough, but he didn't. Okay. Next turn he copied this one, but that's not the, you know, best thing to copy. Keep this on 2 for the adepts if we draw those. And here was the adept, so that's absolutely fine. Let's see, can we kill him if we draw a lord? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. No, we can't. Maybe we just want to start by cracking this. Just remember, that's really nice. Then we just want to get rid of that one as fast as possible. Let's just hold up the adept here. It's a shame we can find a trickster if we do this. But I think I'd rather just wanna. Just block this guy. Actually, considering if we even need to block this, let's just do it. But if he has a removal spell, it's actually quite stupid, this play. Then we're not lethal anymore, so that was a wrong play to block there. I was also thinking, don't block, man. Time of okay. Then that actually turned out okay, because if I have, he wasn't forced to do it there. Okay, that's pretty nice. So we cut him off red here. Then just attack it next turn. Not cutting off red, he has a treasure token, but. But this is okay. I would have won if we didn't block with the adept, to just take the damage. Also, we have a million lords we can draw here, which will grant us unblockable. The Shishus, yeah, that's a bad draw for him. Rin 6, that's a good draw though. I can kill off the Hex Catcher. And now he has to pass the turn. And if we draw a lot, we win. So if we attack with everything, we hit him for 3. And keep him off black mana. And get Ursa Saga back. Then his upkeep will tap something down. Green mana. Then he has no colored mana for the entire turn, and next turn we can attack to win. He can only get back the bouncing from the graveyard. And then you maybe have a removal spell if you drew it. A dash dragon. Okay, that's an interesting line. I think I need to block this. Reason being, otherwise we'll just be able to replay it. And also he can draw Svelun. So that's unfortunate. Come on. Salty. Okay, we'll wait one more turn. Set down the red mana this turn, turn around. Oh, what do we? You can't play this, can't play the salty. No, let's just say cancel. Rather wanna play the subtlety. He must think that something is up here. Something is fishy. I'm playing the Ursa Saga. And now we can go all in. Something was fishy. This game is dragging on. Let's hopefully close it out now. It's a Lord. That should seal it as well. Ooh, and we have 3-1. Only losing to Merfolk. That's how it is being a Merfolk player, you know? You only lose to all of Merfolk players. We'll be right back for the final round here. Okay, relax. We're gonna go a bit down in the level of excitement. And then chill a bit. And we're gonna look at this hand. We're gonna say, this is a mulligan. Not the draw, but this is still a mulligan. But this is a keep. Exactly the same hand, but I don't want a mulligan that much. Damn. We have 2 draws to draw land. A keep. Let's just take back one of the masters. Don't want to go to 5, but this is not good hands we're drawing here. Ooh. Maybe Murktide. Draw land. Land. That's a land. Start by this. If we keep drawing lands here, we can save the Tavara. If we draw a land more next turn, we don't have to force out the Adept. Okay, now I don't want to draw a Tideshaper. So it's not Murktide. It is Murktide, okay. Murktide with Ursa Saga. That's crazy. He's already putting down Legistrators. Interesting line. Interesting that Murktide players suddenly play with... Oh, okay. So it's not Murktide. It's like Hello Fountain. I'm confused. Let's see if we can do something against Salamander Slim. And here in this final round, I also want to do a small little shout out to my sponsor, Cardhoarder. A great service that allows you to buy or rent cards for Magic Online, and they deliver it directly to your account. So I use them a lot. I did before, I partnered with them as well, and I always enjoyed the service. So if you want to test out playing Merfolk, you can definitely just create either buy some cards there or create a loan account and borrow the cards to test out if Merfolk is your style of play. I like it. I like playing Merfolk. It's like really like a tempo-based interactive game you play. You can be both aggressive and controlling. You can adjust all the way through. So either we want to start drawing here with the adept to find something. Actually, the Otavara is really tempting to keep here, but I don't think I want to take that much damage from the Warlock Grove when they're going to pressure my life total. So I think we have to be conservative with our life and put down Otavara. An alternative, we could just trickster the Legislator and upkeep so it doesn't get too connive or something. But it's not likely he's going to go for that. I think we want to save the trickster for the construct token. So let's just play down to Otavara and play down the adept. And we're going to show our master. I'm to a Mortar Vault, okay. Mm-hmm. It's actually hard because if you played the Warlock Grove down here, we could have next turn. We could use the Otavara on a buff the Pledgeshare, so that gives us something to do in the later part of the game. And that's an answer to the Pledgeshare. He cracks his flood strength now. Okay, it's a mill deck. This is crazy. What a brewer. It's been some time since the Blazing Grinding Station. I was all the way out. So we need Hercules Recall, that would be pretty nice. But it doesn't really have anything here. Yeah, we can't do anything about this one. But it does play an island, so we... We have nothing to sack here. It's crazy that it triggers on itself, right? We can actually play it, sacrifice an artifact, and untap with it. Pretty neat. Okay, that screams to high hell that this guy is having a lightning bolt or unholy heat in hand. If he has the unholy heat, oh, grinding station one, session too late. The unholy heat is annoying because he's not close to getting anything up here. So I think I just run out the Svealoon. Again, not too much damage want to take here. So I put out the Mortar Vault. But there was an argument for putting the Warlock Grove down. He's not going to win by Lich's Trading. So I think maybe we should have done that. Don't want to attack here. We just pass. We can't be indestructible, but we can protect with Force Negation. Typically, they don't play Fury. Now we want to create this... you can start milling us here. I think this Force Negation was a good draw. He's a sec. Yeah, Underwood Breach. We're definitely gonna counter that. And I think the Trickster can go here. We need to do as much damage as possible with the Lords. think that's annoying for him. Okay, he has one turn to do all his shenanigans. And then he dies next turn, so it's one more turn to see if we can get the grinding station up and running. But I think we stalled him pretty nicely here, countering his onward breach. Yes, so I think again in this kind of combo deck we really got a good chance with the we're gonna get in the force negations. Probably also Flusterstorm, right? That won't counter, of course. It only counters instants and sorceries. It's something that I think they are. I'm considering if Unlicensed Hearse is worth it here. They run Emrys. The concept is that they're milling themselves. Yeah, I think definitely want to get the unlicensed hearse in. It's good against the Underworld Breach. Graftica's Cage is interesting. He wants to play his Thassa's Oracle. The weird card here, the Thassa's Oracle is the card when into the battlefield you'll mill your deck, but if you don't have enough cards you just win the game. And Thassa's Oracle, they're typically going to mill themselves, and then Thassa's Oracle is going to be in the graveyard and then they can play it from the Underworld Breach. So if you can't enter the, I think Graphic's Cage is actually hurting on them, because now players can't cast players and the priests can enter. So I think that's pretty good. Spring Seas is good against what we saw there. I don't think the Dark Hands is good in this matchup. Salties is okay. Svelun is too slow, and Tricksters they are decent. It's just a couple of lords. They have Ragavan, so I think I want to get in two Dismembers as well. We've got one Subtlety and one Lord again. I don't think Subtlety is the best in this matchup. It can counter the Theft Oracle, that's the reason why I want to have it in there. I think we gotta keep this. Double Hex Catcher is interesting, and we do have a Salty against an early Ragavan, which we might need to do. Here comes the early Ragavan. We can't let this happen. We pitch one of the Hex Catchers. This is, of course, pretty awkward, but this is the reason why we maybe should have considered keeping in the Dark Hands. Okay, Raven is going to come in next turn, but then we have Adept we can play down and trade with it. He might dash it, but then that's not the most crazy. Interesting deck because they're running these mid-rangey. Yeah, here comes Ragavan, it's fine. It's one turn too late, we can't sit around and do nothing here. Ooh, Trickster is also decent. I want to draw a land next turn so I can play the Vial as well. He's gotta kill it now, I suspect. No. Maybe he has one more since he's wanna trade here. Then that one I can trickster. Hopefully a draw lane has to compile as well. Ooh, that was a good hex catcher target though. Really wanna draw here. Land is perfect. We play down either Vial. In the consideration here, I think actually I want to play down Hearse. We can't really counter anything like an Unworld Breach here because we don't have enough targets. So I think I rather just want to remove cards in the graveyard to buff up the Unlicensed Hearse. It can become a pretty big threat. And that also makes the Unworld Breach worth. But it doesn't play that next turn, of course. But is he gonna play for 4 mana? Nothing really that I can counter anyway. But I don't see myself trickstering here. So let's just play down the Hearse and let's get that up and running. And we can take... I just don't think there's any reason to think too much about this because I don't think it really matters. Let's take these the two playable cards. Here comes Legend Shredder. That's not a threat for us, but now it becomes a bigger threat now. That was Emery. I think I just want to tap down the Nest Shredder in upkeep. That eliminates Springleaf Drum value and also the Connive triggers. So I think that's better than holding up Hexcatcher. Maybe counter this. I don't know if they're running any counter spells. Don't think they are actually. The Unlicensed Hearse is also suddenly attacking for a lot. Okay, this is fine. He has to do this because he can't get the mana value up and running from the Springless Drum because we tap this one down. I think I want to do this again next turn. After all, I think I want to consider playing the Lord and attacking. Another is a problem because we can remove the Thassa's Oracle at instant speed at some point. Either spell bomb. Yeah. Not a good turn for him, I would say. Big question if it's worth putting this down for damage. We haven't seen the Urza Saga. I think it is. And then we want to hold up Badalan Hexcatcher. And then we want to trickstering his upkeep. Again, just to stall him as much as possible. Maybe we can actually one-shot him now. I don't think it's worth countering this to sac. We need to sac two creatures. We can kill him instead. He does have either spell bump. Maybe we should have gone for countering it, because then he also nullifies his either spell bump. That's annoying against the unlicensed first, so I don't think we can activate the unlicensed first. I think it's annoying that we are taking out the Lesser Rare. It seems like an important filtering mechanic for the Underworld Breach deck. I don't think there's any problematic cards in the graveyard right now. And now we can't use the spell bump. Let's place another land. Regavan. That I think I want to counter that, actually. Because then you can't use either spell bomb. That's important. Ah, sorry bro, you should have played that first, but now we can't play the UC spell bump. So he can bounce the unlicensed first. I think I want to start by cracking this. So what I want to do is I want to put down the Lord of Atlantis, and I want to use. Now I think we need to. Did I forget to exile here? I think I did. This is not even lethal. Let's just attack with these two. I think I played myself here. This is a bad play. We should not have activated the unlicensed verse. Because it's the grinding station, I need to have not come back with the Imri. And I was like, I can force him to trade, but I can't really. This was a very impatient play by me. Because if I didn't activate it, it was just like meaningless to activate it. Damn! But at least we got the two important ones out there. The grinding station was important to get removed. But it's four cards, I think. We're not looking that hot now anymore. He has a free reign to do whatever he wants. And I think I want to let him hit me here. Adept is fine. He wanted to tap out to draw a card. That's not interesting for him. Unholy Heat. Yes. Then he must have a removal spell for the Lord as well. Ah, okay. So if we draw a Lord, we win. He can only one Unholy Heat in a play here. He's going a bit off here. Okay, so that's a combo. I missed a static. No. I play Thassa's Oracle. So, if we didn't bounce the Alliance's Hearst, if we didn't play that, we would have won the game. Unfortunately, let's take in a Brazen Borrow. I think that's also pretty good to stop the combos. Cutting one hex catcher. That's crazy. I should have won that game. We should have won that game. No! Why did I activate the Unessence first? That's so foolish. Okay, we'll wait for him to sideboard, and here we are. Start the play. This is a cubable hand. Start by let's lead on a cavern here. No Ravens and one that's good for us. That's good news. I think I just want to start by Lord of Valensis here. Yeah, let's do that. Uncountable threats are good, but he can of course just lightning bolt it. He did have the lightning bolt, okay. Or the unholy heat. It's fine. Let's just shredder. Okay. Let's get down to Svedum. Can protect it. I felt we were so much in control, and we were. If we didn't activate the Undying Search, we would have won that game. But that gives us this fun final match. Fun final game of the day. Come on. I don't think this is a Kata counter. This could be. Now the Sailoon will do the heavy lifting from here on out. And that's the thing I wanna just attack with Mudavolt. Ah, damn. Shadow Spear, okay. Okay, this is an aggressive line. He's on 7 now. He can make a 3-3 construct. Should not have sided out Lord of Atlantis in this matchup. I don't know why I did that. Unblockable threats are good. Should have just started out the subtleties, they make no sense. If your combo goes off, it just goes off. That's how it is. But maybe he's thinking so much because it's not easy choices he has. We are presenting a heavy board, and if he doesn't have any removal spells, he has two instants. Two lanes in this graveyard. So it's pretty far away from Delirium. If he even has another Unholy Heat. Come on, bro. I can't take the tension. I showed my hand already. Pretty good play. Okay. So what happens here? He's on 10. Block there, then he takes 6. What if he blocks there? What happens then? Then he takes 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So he can't block there. He can block on the Mudavolt. He can block the Sailoon, but that's just a bad block, right? So I think I need to activate both my Mudavolts and attack here. Because he can't block the Hexcatcher. He blocks the Hexcatcher, he goes to 10, and then he takes lethal damage. it goes to 2, and I have another Mudaval. That's a good draw. This is the best block he can do. This is still stressful. Now we can make another contract token, so we need to dig with the Warlock Grove to find a Lord here. And we side out 3. That's not good. Now we can actually attack and then re-equip. But we are still... So we don't even... Yeah, we are lethal if we draw a Lord. It's not a good situation to be in. We could also draw a trick, so that would be pretty nice. Because I think he's going to attack with the Lich Ritter now. Now we have Delirium. This is like a marathon match. It's hopeful, and I could have won it if we played it properly. Bah! In the second game. Okay, 4 outs. Why did I side out all the Lords are so stupid. He should attack and hit for 3 going up to 5. Oh my god, he's a spell bump. Why is he considering so much when he drew the nuts? And we can't win anymore. I could just find it from the Ursa Seg, of course. No, we think we can't win anymore. A little too late here. Come on. That's a good bounce. And we say thank you for the game. And thank you guys for watching. That was 3-2. We could have probably gotten a bit of a better result. We should have won the last one. But 3-2, I'll take it, it's fine. Thanks for watching. This was a nice little... I think this deck performed really well. And if I want to go to a tournament today, I would bring something like this. I think it looks pretty nice. So thanks for watching, guys. Have a good one. Bye bye.